my last record was called Something to Say, and it was always kind of with the heartbeat of encouraging people that their lives matter and that they have something to say to the world. So I guess with this record, I kind of just thought, well, what if I really let people say it? The idea is to collect your stories, you know, to have people send me their stories. It could be about anything. Just praying that I'll find the inspiration to just to make a unique record that speaks to the very people that I'm reading about. This is the way to the cabin, and like this is probably one of the most beautiful parts of Tennessee. We're just a few miles from my house. Here it is. The concept behind the story of your life is centered around the question, like, what would happen if, as a songwriter, I stepped outside of my own life and my own experiences and asked people to tell me the story of their lives? I don't know, I just had this feeling even several months ago that I was gonna be in a cabin somewhere reading people's stories. I'm spending the first week pretty much by myself, just reading these stories, getting to know these people and their lives and praying about what these songs need to say, you know?
This is the story of your life. You decide how the rest is gonna read. This is your chance between the lines to redefine the kind of legacy.
I'm not sure what size a regular donkey is.
Hey guys.
What's the story of your life, donkey?
I'm gonna keep my hand in my pocket.
Do you have a story you want to share?
They have teeth, right?
I'm reading through these stories, and it's not all flower gardens and amusement parks. It's some pretty heavy stuff. I mean, it's people opening up windows into their worlds, and it's tragedy, and it's loss, and it's illness, and it's abuse, and it's depression, and it's many people that are still working through those things that haven't seen the redemption yet.
This is not just a new pool of inspiration. This feels like a new ocean of inspiration. It's like I'm reading stories from a parent who's concerned about their middle school child, you know, and how kids are calling him stupid and how he just doesn't have any friends. And it's like, stories like that break my heart, you know, and I just start playing and singing like what I would want to say to that kid, you know? Or maybe more importantly, what I feel like God says to that kid. I was made fun of a bunch in school. I was this chubby kid in school. The kids had a heyday with that. Fat Matt. I'll never forget that. And I think to this day, a lot of my self-consciousness comes from being in junior high and like even my need for acceptance and stuff like that. So yeah, new pool of inspiration. I'd say it's an ocean.
I have endured abusive relationships and an abusive marriage. I was living with a broken heart. As if a healing heart or a healed heart or healed life is not something to be grasped. But just sort of admitting that, well, you know, my life's messed up and, you know, maybe I don't deserve to be healed. So I think I'm reading a lot of that in people's stories, just kind of going. It's a whole lot of people that maybe just think that life with a broken heart is just part of the deal, you know?
Guess I always thought living with a broken heart was part of life.
I think people's lives are changed when they hear about how other people's lives are changed. Maybe this will cause a chain reaction for people to kind of step up, come out of the woodwork, and especially for people in the Christian community, you know, who might be tempted to think, I've always got to keep it together. I've always got to have a smile on my face. I've always got to put my best foot forward. Well, that's all well and good, but that's really only a sliver of our lives. What about all the rest of it? What about all the junk?
Everyone loves a story, and I think, I know I do, and when you can put a name and a face with a real life story of what someone's been through, it's like you find yourself connecting with that person and wanting them to win. We're gonna tell the story of other people's lives, and that's the heartbeat behind this whole record, and that's where I think the connection's gonna take place. So the hope with the story of your life is that it will just serve as like a really powerful piece of the puzzle to this whole experience that will allow us all to look into the lives of people and maybe find out something about ourselves. That's how God works, and that's how he works through our stories in life. So I'm excited to see what's gonna come out of this.